Courtnee Roze is drumming for us. Give the drummer some. Yay! On guitar, on bass.
Oh, we got Kenji Tokunaga. Oh my God, this guy. Wait a minute, I got to talk about Kenji.
Okay.
Kenji was the first one in my band, and he was the first one when I didn't have a band. So I said, Kenji.
When you all were a duo.
Yeah, so I said, Kenji, when I get a band, I swear to God, I need you to be in my band. He said, okay, because you know he's real subtle and quiet. So he said, okay. I said, yeah, right. He's not going to come when I get a band. But this guy, he's been with me since day one. That's why I brought him. His work ethic is out the door. When I say out the door, I mean out the door like around the corner. His work ethic is amazing. Always on time, always know the music. Kenji, you know, you have to exceed my work ethic.
So, and you got high standards.
I do.
And you should.
I do.
Yeah.
And people get on me about that, Maggie.
No. Honey, don't accept nothing but the best.
Thank you.
That's what you want for yourself, and that is exactly what you should want from others that are working with you, or else they're not part of your plan.
See, that's why I knew I needed to come here. Because I needed to hear those words, and I needed the world to hear those words because, you know, it's like she's a strict band leader. She's, you know, yes, I am.
But you find that the people who succeeded, you know, like a James Brown and Quincy Jones and a number of others, they didn't play. And that's why we're still talking about them to this day.
Thank you.
You know, go and grab the memoir of James Brown, and you know, written by both his sons. You know, they were complete musicians, and they understood what it was to be that leader.
And not instant gratification. Mm-mm. You have to work to get these things. You see, you know, people on TV, on the Grammy. Oh my God, I want no. But do you know their journey? They had to work to get that. Not sit back and just get by. You know, I don't really care for get by musicians. You know, you want to get by, you could get, you know, go with somebody else.
Yeah,
you know, you got to work to be in a musical.
And keep control of your music too.
Exactly,
because somebody else will hijack it in a minute, in a blink, especially nowadays with their little secret recorders and everything else.
Yeah, I know that already. I got that before my attorney passed away. Rashad, I love that guy. He taught me the music business back and forth.
That's good.
They get the baby face a little twisted, but it's okay.
Oh, folks, we have someone who you will be hearing about for a long time. She is percussionist, singer, producer, and composer Courtnee Roze, founder of The Musical. We've been talking about The Musical. You want to play something else for us?
If you would
set
like
it up.
Okay, cool. Me and Kenji, we're going to play something.
You have to talk to him and tell him what.
Kenji's for Japan. Kenji just know what I like to play.
Oh, he's a mind reader too, huh? Y'all are tuned in.
Yeah, we're very much tuned in. Hey. Come on now.
There it is. And does that one have a number? A name?
No, it's just a break that we do before I do Music Over Love.
Okay.
Because, you know, I sing. I mean, not sing. But
yes,
I
you
sing.
Do. I've heard you sing. You also recite poetry?
Yeah. That's what Music Over Love is. That song. And the fans love that song for some reason. I didn't really anticipated being a single, but they really love that song when I do it. I guess they can relate.
Another part of you that you're sharing. All right. Folks, if anybody has any questions or comments, you're certainly welcome to join us. If you've heard Courtnee Roze in concert, you could or gone to The Musical. Where do you guys play The Musical?
Many
different locations.
Yeah, we just finished playing Joe's Pub. We'll be at Rockwood Music Hall on May 7th, we'll be at Savannah's on May 22nd, and we'll be at Dinosaur Barbecue in Harlem on May 29th. So we have a few shows coming up.
Okay, now that's a new one for me. Dinosaur Barbecue?
It's actually very popular.
I've never heard of it.
Food is phenomenal.
Okay.
So they're going to feed us that day, so I'll let you know. You know I'm a chunky kid. I'll let you know. Yeah, no, it's pretty popular. I've never played there. I've always wanted to, so, you know, that'll be our first time playing
there. I'll have to check it out when I'm up there.
Yeah.
Next month. That sounds cool.
No, I heard
that. I'm going to remember that name, Dinosaur Barbecue.
That's a plug. You guys owe me some money.
Let's talk about the gathering of musicians. How do people get in touch with you? How do you make them a part? Are you going out, in a sense, auditioning all the time?
No.
To be part of your group?
No. I want to get to that point because I think it would be an easier process. But all of these musicians I've built relationships with throughout my career. So, you know, playing various places, the Apollo Theater, like the guitar player that played with me last week, he's like, I played with you at the Apollo. I'm like, oh, yeah, that's right. You know, so all of these relationships I built. Kenji, I've been knowing him for several years now. Drummers, people always talk about my drummers, like Mark Bell, Berto, because they're so amazing. But I'm a percussionist, so I know what a good drummer looks like. But we've all built relationships. I played with all of them in other bands, other venues. So when I got my band, I just make a phone call. Hey, you want to play? That's it. And I'm so happy that I can do that, because not a lot of people can do that. And not a lot of the musicians that play with me, they have standards. You know, they travel the world, so they're not going to just play with anybody. So I feel very honored to be able to pick up the phone. Like, hey, Jay White, let's, you know, that's big.
Yeah. I saw on your website little Alicia Keys. Talk about that.
So I played with Alicia Keys. That was a few years ago. I don't remember what year. On Black Girls Rock. Phenomenal Spirit. That was my first big TV thing. And I actually played the marching band bass drum. I didn't play djembe. I didn't play congas. I played that marching band bass drum, and I'll never forget it. The experience was phenomenal. Alicia Keys, phenomenal. I mean, you know how you meet an artist and they're like, oh my God, I'll never work with that artist again. But she's what you imagine if you had an imagination and you imagine her on TV, like, she's so nice. No, she's just like that. She's just like that. But she's also just like me. She want her stuff right.
That's exactly what I was telling you. You know, it's kind of like when you have friends and there are people that tell you, oh, girl, you can't do that. Mm-hmm. Oh, girl, you know, that ain't nobody going to. Those are the ones that become acquaintances. You move them to the side. People that are still, you know, yes, going in the same path with you, lifting you up, moving you in the right, helping you move in the right direction. Yes. Those are the people you want to be with.
Yes, absolutely.
Because the rest of the people are wasting your time.
I agree. I mean, I don't like to say names, but I remember someone was like, well, you know, I'm not going to be able to learn that music by tomorrow. I said, listen, I play with musicians that learn 3 songs in 1 day. So you telling me you can't learn 4 bars? I can't work with you. I can't.
But at least you found it out ahead of time.
I did. My mom always say that. My mom always says that. Like, because you know what? There's no ethic behind it. I just played with LaChance, that played Color Purple at Joe's Pub. And we had to learn her music. It was, you know, they called me, okay, this weekend is the show, you come to rehearse week. And I didn't, you know, no, I can't learn the music. No, we had to learn her music. And that was that. That was the end of it. If you want to do the gig, you learn the music. That's it.
No half-stepping.
Ain't no
half-stepping. That is for sure. All right. You got the musicians. You got the entertainment.
Right.
And what else?
Oh, and one more thing I wanted to say is that this guy asked me at my show last week. He said, how do you keep all these musicians together? How do you make them, quote unquote, make them come to rehearsal? I said, I don't make anybody do anything. The music is so different because we don't play like anybody else. And they respect me as a leader. And the music is so different and it's so intriguing. And I'm always challenging them. So I'm not like, if I played Chaka Khan last week, I'm not going to play Chaka Khan this week. I'm going to play something else. Or I'm going to make up another song for them to play. So I said, I don't make them do anything. They play with me because they want to.
Yeah.
And that's what I like.
And that's what you want.
Yep.
Exactly. All right, you're going to give us one more little, we got about five
so
minutes.
So I'm going to just do Music Over Love, just the first verse.
All right. Music Over Love, the first verse. Ahead, for those Kenji. Of you who haven't heard it, it's fabulous. Go ahead.
Yeah, Kenji.
All right.
Yes. Come on, now get it on, get it on, get it on, dance. Ha. Music is in the soul, oh man. Come on, love done hurt so bad I can't trust it anymore. And heart to heart seems so bland, so I forget it. I get it on the dance floor, and that's my, and who with it? Now carry on, fellas, it's my world and you're in it. Don't get beside yourself, cause music first and you'll finish. Don't get beside yourself, cause I choose music over love. I choose music over love. Come on, now I choose music over love. I choose music over love. That's it.
She's only gonna give you one verse.
I mean, I didn't know I had time for more.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You got time.
Go ahead, Kenji.
Ah, see? Wet that whistle.
Come on now. Hey, see, it's better than love. Hey, see, it's better than cars. And it's better than sex, money, drugs, and it all. Hey, it's the only thing right that'll get your life. Hey, it'll get you right back to freedom. Isn't it nice? Come on, what love got to do with it? Even Tina was through with it. See, love never loved us. Come on, now, 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 remember? Uh-huh. See, love never loved us. Come on, y'all, remember? Uh-huh. See, love never loved us. Come on, now, 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 remember? Because I choose music over love. Come on, y'all, I choose music over love. And I choose music over love. Come on, now, I choose music over love. Come on, Kenji, now. Hey, come on, come on. Better play, boy. God damn.
You made my soul a burning fire. You're getting to be my one desire. You're getting to be all that matters to me.
Actually just pushed the button.
Well, I'm gonna tell you, girl.